What is HIPEC and why might you go in for this surgery? My guest Kayla will answer these questions, let you in on how her recovery was, and share with us her diagnosis and treatment that led her to HIPEC. But before we jump into my interview with her, let me introduce myself. My name is Jelena, and I was diagnosed with stage 3 rectal cancer in May of 2016. I went through radiation, oral chemotherapy, LAR surgery, also known as a lower anterior resection, the IV chemotherapy FOLFOX, and I had an ileostomy that was later reversed. But there are a lot of treatments out there that I haven't talked about yet, especially for patients that are diagnosed at stage 4, which means that the cancer has metastasized or spread to other organs. So today we're going to talk about one of those options, HIPEC. So let's jump into my interview with Kayla. All right, well, welcome, Kayla. Thank you for joining me today.
Thanks for having me.
So before we get too much into your story, can you tell us a little bit about yourself pre-cancer?
So pre-cancer, I was an active, average 27-year-old. I was a runner. I was went to Pier Bar like daily almost, and grew up on the water, grew up on a lake in southern Michigan, and I was living in Detroit, just living what a typical 27-year-old lifestyle is at that point.
So can you share with us a little bit about your symptoms and then your diagnosis story?
So before I was diagnosed, I had a lot of fatigue, which I kind of passed off because I was working a lot. I had some bouts of explosive diarrhea. I would go work out at Pier Bar and then I would drive home and not be able to make it back to my apartment without having to stop to use the bathroom. Which then turned into some constipation. And by the time we had surgery, I had penciled in stool. I was diagnosed in the ER, kind of. I had an ovarian cyst that we found that was on my right side that was causing a lot of pain after a workout class. Then I had surgery right about a month after that, which we thought we were just removing an ovarian cyst. When they went in and did surgery, they figured out that it was actually a met from my rectal cancer, and they placed an emergency colostomy at that point. And I woke up in the ICU with a stage 4 cancer diagnosis.
What were the steps then after that surgery and your diagnosis?
So after that, we met with a local oncologist backed by my parents, and then I also met with an oncologist in Detroit to go over what our next plan was and like where we were going from there. We ended up going with my local oncologist. We did an egg harvest before I started chemo because I was so young and we wanted to try to preserve fertility for me. We then did a PET scan, an MRI with an enema, and then we did a liver biopsy because I had mets to the liver. And then I did 10 rounds of full fury IRI with Avastin, which is oxyplatin, irinotecan, 5-FU, and leucovorin.
You did those 10 rounds, and was the plan just to kind of do those 10 rounds and see how your body responded and then come up with a new plan after those rounds?
Yes. So the plan was 10 rounds, see how treatment went, see how I handled treatment. And then from there, the goal was surgery. The goal was for my oncologist was a cure, but we didn't know that a cure was possible. We just knew that it was treatable when I was first diagnosed.
Okay. So then after you did those 10 rounds, how did they decide what the next step was? Did they do scans and then that's how they determined what to do?
So we did a follow-up CT after 10 rounds to see how the cancer had responded to my chemotherapy, and then we went and met with surgical oncologists to see what their next steps and if I was cleared for surgery. I had a very good response to my chemo, so my liver mets were no longer showing on my scans, and my primary tumor had shrunk significantly.
Okay. You can come say hi, and then you have to be quiet, buddy, okay? There. So can you tell us a little bit about what is HIPEC, and when did it come into the conversation?
HIPEC is hyperthermic intraperitoneal chemotherapy that is performed under during surgery. It is commonly referred to as the mother of all surgeries. And we started discussing this once we figured out that that my response to chemotherapy did clear me for surgery. It came up with my local oncologist. And then as we went through the major systems, such as the top 10s or the teaching hospitals, we discussed it further with my GI surgeon, and then of course my oncology surgeon.
So you mentioned you met with multiple different hospital systems to talk about this and surgery in general. So how did those consults go with the different hospitals?
So we first consulted with one hospital. The consult was actually very, very poor. They hadn't reviewed my file. My file had been sent over to them and they thought that they were taking on all of treatment. That was not our goal. Our goal was for them to do my surgery and then continue treatment at my local hospital. It was bad enough that they did a digital rectal exam, not knowing that they couldn't feel my tumor based on where it was at. Then we met with a second hospital. It's also a teaching hospital and a top 10, where we met with my GI surgeon only. No fellows came in and talked to me. He knew my case inside and out, and we proceeded with the second hospital because I was no longer a number or a name on a file. I was actually a human and a person.
Yeah, that's definitely a good sign that you're seeing someone that's going to click with you and kind of listen to you, especially at stage four. Like, there's a lot of variables and you want someone on your side and that's going to fight for you.
Yes.
So then why was HIPEC recommended for you?
So HIPEC was recommended because I had only abdominal mets. I had my ovarian met that we found in my first surgery, and then I had the two mets that were on my liver. Due to the fact that there was activity within my abdominal cavity, the goal was to treat the entire abdominal cavity while I was under surgery.
Okay. So then what testing did you have to do prior to HIPEC being approved for you?
So first, my oncology surgeon took my case to tumor board, which is where they meet with the large amount of doctors, from medical oncologists to surgical oncologists to GI docs. Everybody comes into a room and reviews the case and sees if the patient is able to withstand and withhold the surgery. From there, they determined that they wanted a PET scan to make sure that there were no other malignancies that we weren't seeing on my CT scan. And then he also performed a abdominal scope to make sure that we didn't have more malignancies within my abdomen that we couldn't see on scans. To make sure that when they opened me up, that it was a feasible surgery.
So then what exactly does the HIPEC surgery entail?
So for my HIPEC, it was a multiple surgeries. I had my GI surgeon was in there, and then my oncology surgeon was in there as well. So the first thing that they did was they resected my primary tumor, took down my colostomy that had been placed in my first surgery, and placed my ileostomy. They then ablated my liver mets, and then they performed HIPEC. So they performed HIPEC as the last part of the surgery to make sure that they've removed and resected all primary tumor sources that they can see. So from there, they pump a chemotherapy into your abdominal cavity at 103 degrees, and then massage that around for 2 hours. And then they open you back up, remove the chemotherapy back out of your cavity, and close you back up. So I have a scar that runs from my clavicle down to my pelvic bone from my first surgery and also from my second surgery.
So you mentioned they ablated the tumors on your liver. So can you explain what exactly is ablation for those out there that may have never heard of that before?
So ablation is essentially burning the spots that the liver mets were at. Since they weren't visible and they weren't showing on CTs, they didn't think that resecting it was necessary. So they essentially just burn those spots on the liver and kill those active areas.
Okay. And you also mentioned that they took down your colostomy and switched you over to an ileostomy. Was that the intention when they started the surgery, and why did they decide to kind of switch you from one to the other?
So that was the intention with the surgery. My GI doc had talked to me. We knew that we were placing an ileostomy, so I was marked prior to surgery as to where they wanted to place it. The reason for it being was the colostomy was too close to where the primary tumor was. He wanted that to heal back up before they tried to reverse the ileostomy.
Okay, that makes sense. So then it sounds like a pretty intense, in-depth surgery. How long were you in surgery for?
So surgery for me was 10 hours, which was a long surgery.
Yeah, okay. So then what was your recovery like from that?
So recovery was estimated 7 to 14 days inpatient stay. I was released from surgery to ICU for a day because they had to place an IJ, which is right here in your jugular. It's a line that they place in order to give me fluids during surgery. And then they pulled the IJ while I was in ICU and released me the next day down to a step-down unit the nurses were specifically trained in how to handle patients post-HIPEC. I was inpatient for 5 days and released. And then from there, obviously, I slowly recovered with my abdominal muscles coming back into play. No lifting more than 10 pounds for several weeks, no driving a car, but making sure that you're walking and mobile is very important post-HIPEC.
Was there a lot of pain that you had involved? I can imagine there was at least a reasonable amount having that large of an incision.
So they placed an epidural pre-surgery to make sure that pain was not as bad coming out of surgery. And I think we pulled the epidural day 3. And then from there, I was on oral medication, released home with Tylenol and Advil, high dosage. And then I have a very high pain tolerance. So for me, pain is not as much as it is for others.
Were you working during this time? And if so, how long did you take off of work for the surgery?
Oh, I worked up until the day of surgery. And then post-surgery, I took 5 weeks off, but I do work from home and I do have a desk job. So I just needed to be able to sit for 8 hours in order to perform my duties at work. Working for me has been very important post-recovery.
Okay, so after the HIPEC surgery, did they wait a certain amount of time to do scans to see if the surgery had been successful in getting rid of all the cancer?
So post-HIPEC, my local oncologist is affiliated with Mayo, so we consulted with Mayo, and they recommended that I do additional follow-up chemotherapy just to make sure that we had resolved all the issues. So we did 5 rounds of KPOX, which is capecitabine, the pill form of 5-FU, and oxyplatin. And then we did follow-up scans. I pushed for follow-up scans post-HIPEC because my CEA was so low. And then we found out that I actually had an ovarian met on my other ovary at that point.
So once you saw that there was another met or metastasize on the ovarian cyst, then what was the plan from there?
So from there, we then consulted again with my surgical oncologist and my GI doc, and they cleared me for surgery again. So we removed the ovarian cyst. And we talked about doing a potential second round of HIPEC. If it was warranted in surgery, he would determine if they were going to do it or not. He didn't feel it was warranted, so we did not continue with the second round of HIPEC.
Okay, so what is the FOLFOX IRI, and I guess more specifically the Avastin that you did?
So FOLFOX IRI is irinotecan, oxyplatin, leucovorin, 5-FU. So it's the kitchen sink of what we can get for metastatic rectal cancer. They add on Avastin when you are stage 4. It works as almost an immunotherapy, but you don't have to have the immunotherapy markers in order for it to be effective. My local oncologist explained it to us pre me being on Avastin as it cuts off the receptor cells within the cancer. So in his words, it's like taking a baseball mitt and closing it so that that receptor cell can no longer receive the baseball, and it stops the progression of cancer.
Okay. That's a good explanation as to what it does. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I hope you were able to learn something about HIPEC and know a little more about what to expect if you are preparing for this procedure or are considering having it. If you'd like to learn more from other stage 4 patients, you can click on that playlist right up here. Or to hear more about what my experience was like going through treatment, you can click on that playlist down here. Thank you for watching.